Hey guys, it's Kylie. Welcome back to my channel. Couple things. Announcement number one. If you have not already, subscribe to my channel. Because when we hit 200 members, I am doing a giveaway and we are almost at 200 members. So, subscribe. Announcement number two. If you have not already watched the YouTube channel Bailey Sarian. Her name is Bailey Sarian. I'm pretty sure her YouTube channel is called Bailey Sarian. I love her channel. She's beautiful. She does beautiful makeup. She's awesome. She does awesome makeup. She does awesome things. She does Murder Makeup Mondays, where she talks about a murder that's been on her noggin, and then she talks about it while she does her makeup. So I'm like, God dang, that's a great idea, because who doesn't love the podcast My Favorite Murder? And it's similar to that, except some makeup visuals while you're hearing somebody talk about the murder. That's interesting. Brings me to my point. That's a great idea. I'm not gonna take her idea, but I'm gonna make my own idea. And instead of murder, we're gonna talk about conspiracy theories. Now, whether or not I believe in the conspiracy theory, I'm gonna talk about some. I don't know if this is going to be weekly yet or monthly. I don't know how long it's going to take me to do research for it and put the videos together, so we'll fiddle through that. The conspiracy theory that we're going to talk about today is the moon landing conspiracy. Hi, how are you? Hi, how are you? Products that I use will be hopefully in the description box below. Might be using some products that I would not normally use today because it's 8:57. I ain't going anywhere after I do this. So, you know, I am just going to use some makeup. Not my everyday makeup, because I don't want to waste that, because money, makeup is expensive. This is the conspiracy about whether we have actually landed on the moon or not. Dun, dun, dun. July 20th, 1969. A happy place on Earth. A happy time on Earth. People around the world witness Neil Armstrong and Buzz Aldrin plant the little Tootsies on the moon. You know what? Side note, this foundation is actually really pretty. This is the Maybelline Instant Age Rewind, and this has got to be at least 4 years old. The conspiracy behind it is that we have never actually been to the moon. Now, you may ask, why would they fake the landing? Why would they fake landing on the moon and walking on the moon? Well, if you didn't know, there was a little something called the space race between us, the US, and the Russians, and they were competing on who could get to the moon first. So the conspiracy is the reason we faked the moon landings is so we could beat the Russians and anybody else and say, we did it first. Alright, so we've got the main reason on why people would want to fake the moon landing. How would we do it? Why do people think it's a hoax? What makes them think that the landing on the moon, that the video proof that we have, that everything else, what makes them think that that is a hoax? So one of the reasons why people think it's a hoax is because on the moon, there is no wind, all right? There's no wind. But people say that when you look at video or even pictures, it looks like the flag is waving with wind. So how can a flag possibly wave in the wind on a moon that has no wind? Bum, bum, bum. So what really happened with the flag, and the reason behind it having its wave look to it, is because they actually put a mechanism, and I heard it called a mechanism, not just like a wire, it was a mechanism, put into the flag, like rolled up into it, so that when the flag was on the moon, it would look like the flag was flying and not just, you feel me? So they put this mechanism in it, but on the way there, it kind of got all crunched up and everything, so it actually looks like the flag is flying, which actually I think it makes it look way better than if it was just this straight, stiff flag. I think that would look really funny. But when they have some video of it, of them putting the flag up. It's all, you know, crinkled and stuff. So when they bump it, it almost looks like the flag is actually waving, but it's just because of the way it is now formed, makes it look like it's waving in the wind. Debunked. Do you think that is debunked? Or do you still believe there was wind? I also think we should make this a drunk conspiracy theory series. Drunk conspiracy theory theories. Drunk conspiracy theory series. Ha! Make it a little more interesting. Have you ever seen the show Drunk History? Oh my gosh, that's my favorite. We could do that. Let's do that. We're doing drunk conspiracies instead of drunk history. It's drunk conspiracies. Another thing conspiracy theorists have an issue with is the stars in the background of the photos on the moon. Now, the issue with the stars is there ain't no stars. If you're on the moon with a beautiful black background of stars, why is there no stars in the pictures that we're seeing? Conspiracy theorists believe that when people took the photos, they didn't want to take pictures of the stars because they would be missing out on constellations and people could make, you know, star patterns and look them up, or they just wouldn't look like real stars. There's a lot of theories behind it, so they just left out the stars. Well, if you're a photographer or a photography hobbyist, you take pictures, you know some things. You know that taking certain pictures requires to higher or lower the exposure on your camera. It's a setting. The cameras that they had when they went to the moon, their exposure was, I believe it's really low. When you take a picture really fast, the exposure is really low. If you're taking a picture over time, then it's really high. Correct me if I'm wrong. I could be wrong, but I thought it was like low and high. So if you have it low, right? Is that right? Am I wrong? I might be wrong. Now I don't know. I don't know anymore.
What am I talking about?
Basically, like if you're running really fast, you want your exposure to be high because you want to be able to capture it all, right? Am I on the right page? But if you're catching something over time, you want it to be really low. Did I just totally switch what I just said? Now I'm confused. Moral of the story is the exposure time was set to something different than what it should have been if you wanted to catch a picture of the star. Their exposure on their camera was set to something that wasn't going to be able to capture the stars. Beauty blender. Oh, how I love you.
Oh no. I'm so glad it landed this way and not brush side down, because that'd be gross.
Another reason why people think this is a hoax is because when they landed, there is no like burn marks, there's no like sand up and dust all over the place, nothing. When they landed it, it just looks like it was just sat there perfectly fine. Why isn't there any marks? Why does it look perfect? Like, we just placed you there. The reasoning behind this little hoax situation is because on the moon, everything is a 16th, I believe. I believe it is a 16th of its actual weight on Earth. So when you're landing this giant thing of a massive beast on the moon, it's actually little bitty tiny lightweight on the moon. So when you're landing this giant foot, like of the thing, instead of like 1,000 pound weight and all this stuff, you're getting like a quarter of what an actual, of like what a car tire pressure would be. So when they're landing on the moon, the pressure that you would think would be is not even relatively close to that. Basically, it's really light. It's not heavy, so it wouldn't blow stuff all over. It wouldn't make big imprints, you know. It's just there. You feel me? Now let's get some eyebrows on because I'm freaking myself out. Looking like an alien. Do my eyebrows look even? No. Do they look the best? No. Do you want to judge me? No, you do not. Thanks. You drink wine, try to tell a conspiracy theory, and do your makeup at the same time. Tell me how easy it is. Tell me, okay? Now we've talked about several things that were faked, that conspiracy theorists believe were faked. Now let's talk about how these were faked.
If you must know.
Stanley Kubrick. He was an American film writer, producer, screenwriter. Is that all the same? No. Director. Yeah, a film director, a screenwriter.
What?
Yes. And a producer. So, conspiracy theorists believe he is the one who helped all of this movie magic that we all believe is to be, you know, everybody walking on the moon. He is what helped make this all come true. Conspiracy theorists believe that Stanley Kubrick is the one who did this because in 1968? Seven. Eight. I can't remember what year. I'm pretty sure it was the year before we landed on the moon. Stanley Cooper came out with the movie 2001 Space Odyssey. It was believed that Stanley helped NASA create a fake film set. Either there's two different theories. One's on Area 51. And one is on just in somewhere in Hollywood. But they believe he helped create a film set to fake the moon landing. And the reason they believe it was him is because 2001 Space Odyssey, which was a movie about a voyage to Jupiter. And at the time it was said to be, it was a scientifically accurate depiction of space flight, special effects, and imagery. So basically, he was the man to see if you wanted to make it look like you were in space, because apparently his movie looked pretty darn realistic, or at least it had some realistic, you know, things about it. Now, apparently, all of the footage that you can find now of Neil Armstrong's first steps on the moon and all that, you can find it all over the internet. You can find it on YouTube right now. But apparently, all of these are obviously duplicates of the original, and the original is completely lost. So that is another thing about conspiracy theorists. They say, all right, you created all this. Why do you not have the original footage? It is some of the most important footage of the United States history. How can you misplace this? And NASA's reasoning behind this is because, I mean, back then they used to film things, they'd keep it on tapes and file it in tapes, and then sometimes old tapes would get recorded over. So the landing on the moon was not labeled well enough, apparently, and somebody recorded over it. So, hope that wasn't you. Could have been your grandpa. Your grandpa could have done that. Your grandpa could have recorded over that footage. Thanks, grandpa. I mean, if it's my second birthday you're recording over, that's one thing, but the landing on the moon? Seriously? So, conspiracy theorists have a problem with that is, like, where's the original footage? Which, I mean, we're still looking at actual footage of it happening. It's just, you know, recorded footage of the recorded footage. But theorists have an issue with it because that could have been tampered with in some way. Go sit down, Grandpa. Really, I don't know what more the lost footage has to do with anything other than how? Grandpa, what were you doing? Losing that footage. Take a seat, Grandpa. So you might be asking or saying, yo, but there was multiple trips to the moon. Neil and Buzz, I mean, you are special, you were the first people on the moon, but hey, there's been more people on the moon. So were they all fake? Conspiracy theorists believe so. They have photos. One of them is from Apollo 15. Apollo 11 is the first, right? The first one to make it on the moon. Apollo 15 was another one, and there are photos from Apollo 15 that show pictures miles apart, but they have the same exact backdrop. The mountains, they line up perfectly. So conspiracy theorists say, hey, you just changed a little bit on the foreground and, you know, the background, hey, You forgot to change it there, buddy. If you really think about it, there are a lot of factors that play into this. When you are driving along and you're like, hey, wow, that's so pretty out there in those mountains. It's a really pretty mountain view. I really sure like it. Beautiful. You keep driving and driving and driving, and you're in open space. The only thing ahead of you, there's no tree line, there's no fog, there's no pollution, there's nothing. So you can drive miles in the same, you will see the same background. So that is how it gets debunked, because you can drive and drive and drive, and if you don't have anything blocking your view or disturbing it or distorting it or anything, it may look exactly or pretty close to the same thing. Think about it. Do you believe conspiracy theorists on that? Or do you believe NASA and all the debunker? I'm just trucking along here. Trucking along. Okay, so we talked about the flag. Okay, so the theories that we've talked about is the flag waving, the stars in the background, the landing and no crater being formed, how that would have all been created with Stanley Kubrick, the photos. Now let's talk about one more thing, and this one gets a little bit darker, so this isn't for the faint of heart. I mean, if you follow anything with space culture or any of that, I mean, you already know about it. A lot of people already know about it, and it's part of our history, but it's kind of a harsh thing to think about when people think of it as a conspiracy theorist. It gets a little harder, I think. I don't know, for some people. And this part goes back to Apollo 1. Apollo 1 was scheduled to launch January 27, 1967. Ouch, I just poked my eye. And this was the first manned Apollo mission. There were a lot of design faults in Apollo 1 that led up to the deaths of three different astronauts. Virgil Gissom, which they called Gus, Ed White, and Roger Chaffee, I think is how you say it. I might be wrong, so I'm sorry. So those were the three pilots, astronauts of Apollo 1. So what happened was they were scheduled to launch January 27th, 1967, 2 years before the Apollo 11's landing on the moon. There were a lot of design flaws in the, what do you call it, the spacecraft itself. Mainly in the capsule. One of the biggest design flaws in it was the hatch that was inside the capsule was designed so it was impossible to escape quickly. You know how hard it is to do your lip liner while you're talking? It's impossible. And damn near impossible. It's hard. Don't judge how my lips turn out today. I can't talk and lip line, all right? So what happened was the capsule caught fire starting somewhere from the left side, which was where Gus was, and there is some audio on YouTube, which I won't link because I don't want people to watch it that who don't want to watch it, but I mean, if you just search Apollo 1 audio, you'll find it. It gives audio back and forth from Apollo 1 to Mission Control. Is that what you call it? Mission Control. Back and forth, they're talking, all this stuff. They have a lot of communication problems, which was another flaw. So they're having a ton of communication problems. They're trying to fix it. And then a fire starts and you can hear screaming and it's horrible, it's awful. If you don't want to be sad, don't listen to it. It's sad, it's horrible, it's awful. Spoiler alert, the conspiracy is that NASA wanted to kill off these three men. So they all died because it caught fire, the capsule caught fire, and they were unable to escape because of the flaw in the capsule or in the escape door where they couldn't get the door open soon enough. They all died in under 3 minutes, and it was sad, it was horrible. So that was the one of the many causes of deaths taking place on there. Like I said, the door was not the only flaw within the whole spacecraft. That was not the only flaw. There was a lot of things wrong with it. So these men lost their lives. Sad. So what conspiracy, I don't think I like that color with this look. So the theory behind this one is that basically NASA wanted to keep them quiet. They were going to come forward with the reality of it being fake, of them not actually going to the moon. So they killed them off. So after they basically, you know, killed these guys off, horrible, they got Buzz and Neil, replaced them with Buzz and Neil, took them up, and Buzz and Neil have apparently kept their mouths quiet for 50 years now, along with thousands of other people, because it takes a lot of film crew, you know, to do something like that. It takes a lot of people to build props. You got your camera people, your prop people, your choreographers of people, you know, they gotta tell them what to do, how to do it. There's also a lot of debunking with the actual, our spacecrafts were way ahead of our film time. We didn't have the equipment to film in the way that it would take for somebody to fake it, but we had the equipment to actually get to the moon. Does that make sense? We had the equipment to get to the moon, but we didn't have the film equipment to fake a landing on the moon. Does that make sense? Because you would have to slow motion it. We didn't have that stuff. That's a whole thing I'm not getting into because I don't know exactly how to explain it, but I just know we didn't have the film equipment to do it. So, allegedly. I'm not saying allegedly enough. I hope I'm not offending anybody. Sorry. Basically, that is pretty much it. Those are the main theories that I have found about landing on the moon and why or why not it is a hoax. Let's recap. We landed on the moon because of space race. I mean, that, yes, that I think that is a true thing. There was a race for the space. We've got the flag. We've got the stars. We've got Stanley Kubrick. We've got the, you know, the landing and the no crater whole thing. We've got the photo differentials, lost footage, where'd it go? I mean, you can still find it on YouTube, but where'd it go? And then finally we have the tragedy of the people from Apollo 1 who apparently were killed off to cover up everything. So, what I want to know is, do you believe the moon landing conspiracy theory, or do you believe that we really have been to the moon? I want to know what you think and why you think it. There really wasn't a lot of theories about why the moon was fake. None of it, personally. I will tell you my personal opinion on this one. I do believe that we've been on the moon. It is really hard for me not to believe it. And a lot of these theories debunked so fast. Like, I thought it was going to be a bigger conspiracy theory, I guess. I thought there was going to be more in-depth reasoning and more believable stuff, but it was all debunked so fast and so just well, I guess, that, I mean, I always believed it. I always, you know, believed that we went to the moon, but this just proved it even more to me, I guess. I hope you like the look that we created. Again, I am going to try to list every single product in the description box below. I want to hear from you what conspiracy theory you want to hear next. I also want to hear your thoughts, and please don't forget to subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. We're doing a giveaway at 200 people. Hit that thumbs up button if you liked it, and don't forget to ring the bell. We'll see you in the next one. Bye!